nicely. Simmons throws a check that ignites the crowd here at Scotiabank, who were trying to get on Andre Vasilevsky.
Now you got Perry and Maroon going after Simmons, and wisely so. Just get out of there. It's about timing, understanding. Turn your cheek. Now you make the other guys look foolish.
Well, Perry's may have found a partner over on the far side. And
don't give them a chance to try to get anything out of it. And the last thing you want to do is lose one of your key players in a fight. Let them talk to themselves. That's a wise play by Simmons to just turn your back and look at the scoreboard. Don't get involved.
Brawl here. Started with Corey Perry, and then everybody got involved, and here it is.
It almost seemed to be diffused, and then Simmons goes after Hedman, and now you got Lavushkin. It's a hard punch from Perry, and it's the one is Morgan Rielly ended up in a couple of different fights. Found himself trying to hold off Maroon. That happened for a while. And then he ended up the 244s later on as Maroon got away from the pile, was separated and taken away. And Rutta, who went after Blackwell, ended up coming back and getting to Morgan Rielly. And Morgan Rielly absolutely fed him one as he was falling down here.
Rielly evened his scorecard on the night.
Did he ever?
Back-to-back fights.
You know, this all started really with Perry after the hit that Simmons made. He's the one that started the talking with Simmons. In came Maroon. There's the aftermath of Rutta as he went after Morgan Rielly.
Paul Dvorsky is the series supervisor, and there'll be a full report on this. And there might be some suspensions out of this as well.
You know, at the beginning, credit to Simmons, he really did try to just defuse it and ignore Corey Perry and ignore Maroon, but the aftermath in the corner as we went for break, guys couldn't help themselves. And I know if you're Sheldon Keith and you're watching Morgan Rielly, how important yeah. he is. You know, when Hedman became the target, that changed things for the Lightning as well. They got back into the pile. Oh, welcome to the playoffs, guys.
Tone was set that game in Tampa in April, and I guess nobody's surprised at a five-goal game that this might have erupted.
That's how it all began. One hard hit, not a dirty hit, but look at Perry. He's chipping away at Simmons, couple of slashes, a little bit of talk. Maroon sees that that's happening. He comes in, and as I said, Simmons, the veteran, knows, hey, it's a 5-0 game. I'm not going to get involved, not going to do anything. At the end of it, players just couldn't help themselves, and you end up with pretty much everybody squaring off at one point.
John Cooper's expression hasn't changed much throughout the game.
You see the ice bag with Morgan Rielly. That's for me going, it's hands. I mean, how many guys have lost a great opportunity to play in a needless fight? And I'm sure Kevin Bieksa can tell a few instances of not only his own hands, but other fighters. And here in a 5-0 game, you just don't want to jeopardize what's been just an amazing start for the Leafs here on home ice in game number one.
And Rielly will head off now as well. Everybody is involved might be sent to the respective room. I was going to say, John Cooper surprised me a little today. He actually volunteered the comment, if